MagiSwords! Logo Tutorial!
Hello friend! This is a quick tutorial showing how to recreate the Mighty MagiSwords logo in Photoshop. Someone left me a comment in April 2017 asking me to make this video. That's a few years ago now, but I'm sure this will still be relevant. Ah, well, let's get on with it anyway. You're going to need two publicly available fonts, Becker Black NF and Tip Top, as well as a few assets that I've provided in a folder, including the logo background, an image with all the colours we'll need, and some alpha channel videos I've made in case you want to make an animated video version. Links for all these things are in the description. Start off by opening Photoshop. I'm using the current version of Creative Cloud, but any old version should work, as we'll just be using basic features. Create a new document at 1920 by 1080 pixels resolution. Import the textless logo background, as well as the color sample image. Put that out of the way in the corner somewhere. We're going to start with the top bit of text that says Mighty in the original logo. Choose the text tool and set the font to Becker Black NF. Enter whatever you want it to say, set the size to 180 points, and set horizontal scaling to 120%. Choose the warped text option up here. The style we're going to use is Shell Lower. Change the bend property to minus 20% and the vertical distortion to plus 10%. Press OK to confirm these settings. Right-click on the text layer you just made and choose Blending Options. Add a drop shadow. Get the drop shadow color from the color sample image and set the following settings. Normal blending, 50% opacity, 50 degrees angle, global light off, 15 distance, 100% spread, and 0 size. Your top text should be complete. The next thing we need is the big text at the bottom, which originally says MagiSwords. Create some new text with the text tool and set the font to Tip Top. Enter whatever you want the text to say. Set the size to 450 points and the vertical scaling to 200%. You can also adjust the horizontal scaling at this point if you think it's not wide enough. Set the color of this text to the main text color from the sample. Choose the warped text option again. The style we want this time is bulge. Set the bend to minus 45%. Right-click on this new text layer and go to blending options. Add a stroke. For the stroke color, grab the color mark stroke on the sample. Use the following settings: 45 points stroke width, outside, normal blending, and 100% opacity. Duplicate the layer. Go to the blending options for the new layer, turn off its stroke, and add a gradient overlay. Set the following settings: normal blending, 100% opacity, minus 90 degrees linear gradient, and make sure reverse is switched off. Now, click on the gradient and choose any preset that has two colors. Click on the color on the left side and select the gradient dark color from the color sample. Then do the same for the right color and gradient light. Move this new layer a bit down and to the right. Right-click on the layer and choose Rasterize Layer, then right-click on the layer again and choose Create Clipping Mask. Your still image logo should now be complete. If you're going to export it, I suggest you do that as a PNG. That way it won't lose any quality, and if you hide the background layer, then it saves the transparency too. If you just wanted a still logo, then you should be finished at this point. But in the show, it's accompanied by sound effects, a voiceover, and the logo glints in the light in one of two ways. The first version seems to have been used for the mini webisodes before the show got a full TV series. For this version, you'll need to go back into Photoshop and export just the lower text on its own to a PNG file. Reopen this PNG in Photoshop, hold Ctrl and left-click on the single layer. This should select all of the visible pixels. Use the eyedropper tool to get the light blue color from the image or from the main text color sample. Now go to Edit, Fill, choose Foreground Color and press OK. Your logo should now be a solid light blue. Save this to a separate image. Open Vegas Pro. I'm using Vegas Pro 15, but other versions should be fine, as again, we're just using basic features. Set the project settings to 1920 by 1080 pixels, progressive scan, and 23.976 frames per second. Import your logo image and the background if you kept it separate, and on a track above that, import the version of the logo text you turned completely blue. For some sample audio, I included the original title audio in the folder, and I also included a version with just some similar sound effects in case you wanted to record similar audio yourself. Import the original audio to your project as a guide for where to apply the effect. Make some markers for when the sword unsheathing sound starts and ends. Make your blue logo image start and end at these points. Go into the blue image's pan and crop settings and go to the mask timeline. Choose the rectangle mask tool and draw a very tall and thin mask, like I'm doing here. On the left, change its feather type to both and the feather percent to 5.5. For the beginning keyframe, rotate the mask slightly clockwise and place it so it just touches the left edge of the text. Make a second keyframe at the end, rotate it slightly anti-clockwise, and make it just touch the right edge of the text. If you preview your project now, a bar of shiny light should glint across the text. That's all for that one. Let's look at the second effect. This one has some proper animation over it, rather than just a simple shine effect. Set up the project the same way as with the previous version. Import the background, your logo, the blue single color logo text you made, and some sample audio to time the effect against. Go to the effects for the blue single color image and add the HSL adjust effect. Drag the luminance slider up to the max. This will make the image turn white. Find the shine effect video I provided and place it on the track above your now white logo image. Make it start where the sword unsheathing sound effect plays. Right-click on this new event and go to its properties. Go to the Media tab and switch the Alpha Channel mode to pre-multiplied. Now, on the white logo image track, find and press the button over here labeled Make Compositing Child. Change the compositing mode on the shine effect track to Multiply Mask. If you preview your project now, the shine effect should dance across your text. Finally, find the sparkle effect video I've provided and place it on a new track at the top of your project. Make it start about 4 frames before the shine effect below ends. Again, go to this event's media properties and change the alpha channel mode to pre-multiplied. Now the final thing you need to do is go to this track's track motion and move it so it touches the top right of your logo, something like this. That should be everything. Here's a few examples that I came up with to demonstrate.
Twangy mouth harps, stinky body forks, crinkly wrinkly, hungry guinea pigs.
So, thanks for watching. If you do make use of this, please let me know, as I'm fairly certain absolutely no one will. At least I had some fun making this. If you like this, please press the like and the subscribe, leave a comment telling me my voice is sexually beautiful. Share with your friends, all that nonsense. If you really like this, please consider donating to support my channel via PayPal, or pledging to support me monthly on Patreon. You can see my current Patreon supporters on screen right now, and I can tell you personally, these people are beautiful and amazing. Love you, bye bye.